Welcome to Tech Review by Irdi, and today we're going to post a review of the Dromida Series Vista FPV with camera. So let's go ahead and take a look inside the box here. I've already assembled it and de-assembled it, because one of the factors that I did see on my first flight mission was that these bumper areas here, where the blades come out, there's no prop protectors at the moment. I might manufacture or fabricate some, but I hit a couple times on the rear side of this, and with that in mind, it cracked, so I did have to do some repairing here. Dromida's company that does this has parts that you can order, and they have basically everything you need, from every screw to every wire. You can actually customize these. The frames are about $5 and then some changed. You can also get the bearing sets, which there's gonna be two on each side of these. What I use to help protect these corners here is just basically an aluminum tape. Real lightweight, very durable. They'll take a beating first, kind of like a 3M mask, but a little bit heavier duty. So if I did have to replace the frame, you would be able to replace this black small outlet frame that's on the inside, minus the coloring here. In the box, we also have the transmitter. And this is, like I said, already been assembled here. I've taken the precautions of taking out some of the posts and all that while I was doing this work last night. These posts are actually in already, and they have a small clip pin to go in there to hold them in with the gears. But you can also buy these replacement sets here. These are like $1.99 for a full set, each piece. We have the 1001 tactic view camera. Now there is an option to buy a camera with the battery pack that snaps in, or you can buy the battery pack themselves online. They're starting to come in more abundance, but there's the Wi-Fi camera there. It plugs into the drone's battery here, or like I said, you can buy a small battery to self-power it, and it gives it longer flight time for the main drone. So with that in mind, there is the TransFlash SD card right there, a micro SD card, if you will. This is a 2 gig one that's in there now. I have the primary blades that I've been using for the first maiden flight, as well as a screwdriver comes with that, and these are all sealed in plastic. Here is the Lilo charge here. The charger here goes to any 5-volt USB. I wouldn't exceed 2 amps on these. It did get a little quirky with one of the batteries last night on that, but with that being said, you know, the smaller the amperage that you plug this into, like a PC or a laptop, it's going to take a little longer, but your home chargers, like cell phone chargers, and I'll watch what you're putting that into. Anyways, a second replacement set of blades and the screws to go with those as well to fasten them down into the axles here. And I have a second battery as well. Right. Also, you'll get an instruction manual. You'll get the technical update here showing you the changeover on the covers. And again, you can buy all these replacement pieces. You can actually build a full Vista FPV or UAV if you wanted to by just buying all the component parts. But why would you do that anyways? But like any hobby, you can buy all the individual replacement parts. And that was just a warning guide there for the battery. That's right. So basically, that's what you get in the kit. These sell for $139.99 plus some change. You'll find different vendors online to be all over the place. And this one here I got for cheaper than that, considering I bought it off somebody that just bought it. So with that in mind, we'll go ahead and take a maiden flight here shortly. And I'll put together some videos on how we reconstruct this backup. Now we're going to go ahead and calibrate the Vista drone. Basically, there is a set of instructions for this. What we need to do first is turn on the controller here, and you're going to zero out all the trim. To do so, you're going to move left and right on both sides of this, as well as the up and down. Not so much the throttle, but it's a good idea to go ahead and dead center it. We'll go ahead and move left and right until we get a long beat. I think I was pretty close before. There we go. And we'll do the other side as well. Let's move back just in case. Okay, I was off. And you'll get to one section before it makes no sound. And if you move back the other direction, there we go, there's dead center. We'll do the same as well up here. Okay, all the way in that direction, it's close to it. Okay, now the next step is to take the drone, place it on a flat surface, and power it up. For the series here, we just need to plug it in. Okay. And is complete already, calibrates very quickly by the red flashing and flickering light at a rapid pace. Okay, now what we're gonna do is set the calibration to normal mode, which in this case here should be flight preset. Oh wait, hold down the throttle, hit it again, and it's orange. There we go. Okay. Now to put it into calibration mode, all we're going to do is move the throttle down to the right, and we're going to also move this down to the right. It'll start flashing, let go of the controls, your steering will be dead center, your throttle will be at zero, and it has been calibrated. Now, for all of you asking about why the orange mode here, if you're flying outdoors, the orange mode is a little bit more agile, quick to have a response reaction to your control system. It's kind of full power. If you left it on blue, it's better for indoor. There's a 25% cut in power. If you read through the instructions, it basically, you know, it tells you and it details the four different modes that you've got capability. You've got regular flight mode for outdoor, which is kind of like this here with the orange, but you also got the blue for the interior. And then if you press the systems here, you'll see a blinking, stability is off. The drone will also go into the mode to let you know stability is off. And that works for the blue as well. So we'll go back to blue, hold it in, press it again, and you're in blue mode.
Okay.
Well, as in Tough Drones, the Dromida Vista does not disappoint. It is a very tough drone. It's modular in design, and Dromida does make all the individual parts for you to replace if needed. I do recommend this to beginner quad flyers, just because it is some flexibility in some of the body panels as well as the chassis. And as for parts, they're very easy to get. For a price point of $149, the Vista FPV may or may not soothe your appetite for camera drones, but with that, there's a UAV that's around $89 out there to be had. Another thing is that the Vista comes in four different colors. With that in mind, these different colors individualize the band that these run on 2.4 gigahertz. So therefore, you can fly four of them in the same room and compete in a little bit of FPF or UAV racing. My recommendation for all beginners, definitely buy a couple extra parts with these. I would definitely go with another spare battery if possible. These are the higher end batteries, 850 milliamps, I believe, as opposed to the 750. But definitely go with buying an extra battery set for the Dromida Vista. You won't be disappointed. Well, again, another drone in review. So as before, please subscribe to Tech Review by Irdi, and we'll be making some more reviews on some more drones and RC products very shortly. Just stay tuned, subscribe, and we'll see you later.